obsessed with making him president. A Columbus Circle dream, a firework parasol, sleeping in a shrinking tent. And I see no end in sight when the permanent house guest is Frank Lloyd Wright. Hemisphere black and dance with the Ant-Man crowded on the sweet front. Galway Kennel says she came like a comet, tapping beer out of Claremont. Philippine Mahogany, Benjamin Franklin featured on the drapes. Crimson Beach met with lightning and she'll never ever be replaced. And I see no end in sight when the permanent house guest is Frank Lloyd Wright. The father would cringe every time the mother would drive a nail in the wall. And a big portrait of a bald eagle flew in the Asian hall. The famous little genius with cape and Malacca came there in the closing back rooms. Each cold summer supper in the shelter of a hemlock with Greek dolls and spoons. And I see no end in sight when the permanent house guest is Frank Lloyd Wright. Prefab number one in the shade or in the sun, anybody's able. The desert trolls died in the wintertime, leaving the tempered glass table. Japanese art in earth tones and a couple Rockwell rebrews. Old man pines leaning at attention, the mountain low grows and grows. And I see no end in sight when the permanent house guests break Lloyd Wright.
Corn Oreos, that would be awesome. How's
yeah,
that?
Someone ordered a green cake and
you're eating the paper.
Oreo cookies like this big.
No, I'm not.
That's the Janelle cannonball.
Okay. So this week.
Describe the
so this week,
flavor.
Lemony lemon. It reminds me of the Lorax.
The what?
Because it's yellow and small and cute and
tastes
adorable.
Like
I thought the Lorax was orange.
Well, his little mustache is yellow. Cute.
So this week,
we have 2 dozen cupcakes.
Due
on the 15th.
2 dozen cupcakes?
And that's it.
Are you serious?
Uh-huh. And knowing it's half the battle.
Giorgio! This is Kelly. You guys have not met her yet on film. She is the best cookie baker ever to grace the planet. Especially our bakery. Beach Bucket Bakery. And you're stocking us today?
I am.
So what flavors
redoing
did you bring us?
Display. I just have chocolate chip cream cheese filling today.
Sweet. Oh man, let me see. I'm going to get a close up. Hooray. Cream cheese filling?
Yes. Yeah.
Nice. I totally want to take you and introduce you to Don over at Carolina Cupcakery.
I haven't loved that.
They're doing the soft opening. Actually, it may be their hard opening on the 23rd of this month. And I've never actually met her until this past Sunday.
Uh-huh.
She was super cool.
Awesome.
Yeah. It was at the Granby Theater thing that
oh,
we went
cool.
to.
Uh-huh.
She was super nice. And I totally want to see her new location. Evidently,
where is
it's
the new
huge.
One?
Where's the new location, Tim?
Norfolk, somewhere.
Norfolk.
Somewhere in Norfolk.
Pretty sure.
Let's take a road trip to Manio and go see her.
In Manio? Yeah.
No. Not a field trip.
That would be cool. But yeah, if you want to go with us, I totally want to go that evening. If they're, I think she's doing an evening thing because she's on, I can't say what she's on. I don't know if I can say what she's on legally or not, so I'm not going to say anything. A popular television show. And they're producing, or are they releasing it on that night?
The
23rd, September 23rd. I don't know what day of the week that is, but.
Sunday?
Let me look at our calendar. It is a Sunday, actually.
Nice.
So that works for us, at least.
We'll be there.
So, anyway, if you want to go. But this is Kelly. Kelly has her own display, which she is filling right now. And seriously, if you have not tried her cookies, they are insanely good. My brother's favorite is the ginger lemon. We even made a cupcake in honor of Kelly recently called the ginger lemon cupcake. It was really, really good. Mine is the oatmeal raisin, and especially when you did it with the blueberries.
I'm gonna do those again soon.
Holy smoke, blueberry raisin cookies.
I don't think that's gonna fit.
They were super, super good. And then there's the chocolate chip, and then there's the mint chocolate chip, and then there's the peanut chocolate chip. And you do the strawberry lemon, right? The strawberry lemonade. Nice.
Yeah.
Those are really good too. We haven't had those in a while though. That's more of a summer flavor though. Yeah.
We haven't.
Let me ask you this.
For fall. Yes.
Because we're gonna do pumpkin palooza soon. Everybody's freaking out about the pumpkin.
Mm-hmm.
Do you have a pumpkin flavored cookie?
I don't.
Do you want to do a pumpkin flavored
cookie?
You totally should. Because I'm trying to put together a pumpkin brownie right now. I know.
That sounds good.
Last year we did pumpkin fudge that came out super good, and we did pumpkin cannonballs, which came out really good, and we did a pumpkin, remember that pumpkin caramel that we did?
Yum.
And we dipped them in chocolate? Yeah, those are really good too. So we're going to do everything pumpkin for like an entire day, kind of like Sugar Palooza that we did, but everything's going to be all pumpkin.
Have to brainstorm on
that. Yeah. So if you can figure out a pumpkin cookie.
Yeah.
Even if it's a sugar cookie with a pumpkin filling or pumpkin spice.
Pumpkin shape.
There you go. Pumpkin shape. Totally. We're going to do.
Shape.
I don't know if you saw that picture on Facebook or not, but the pumpkin palooza, yeah. There you go. You do the pumpkin shape, and Jen can frost them. And Tim and I will eat them. So, yeah. So that's Kelly. Welcome to Kelly. You will see more of her. I promise. All right. Today we're going to talk a little bit about cookie butter. Specifically, Trader Joe's cookie butter. We went out there this morning, picked up some, and we bake it into our cake. We also roll or fold it into our buttercream. It's super, super crazy good. And we just so happen to put it next to one of Kelly's awesome chocolate chip cookies. We're going to talk about it for a second. And in order to do so, I'm going to let Tim and Jen kind of describe what cookie butter tastes like. Because it's not peanut butter, it's not almond butter.
And it's not cookies.
Yeah, so go for it.
You first.
It's a brand new package.
Let's look at it. Hey, yeah, this will look like when you first open it.
And tasty. These are clean spoons, by the way.
No, they're dirty.
We just licked them clean.
What's the first thing you taste when you try it, Tim?
It's hard to say.
It is hard to say, isn't it?
It definitely tastes like just a liquefied cookie.
Like a pureed cookie.
Yeah, I don't know what kind.
Do you get the ginger out of it?
I can't even talk.
It's got a little grittiness to it, which I like.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Jen's over here freaking out. What's the first thing you taste or think of when you try it, Jen? Because that's the most common question we get when people come in and we say, we have cookie butter cupcakes.
Try them.
What kind of cookie do you think that tastes like?
It reminds me of a pretzel.
A pretzel?
A sweet one.
A sweet pretzel.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's a good analogy, though.
I know you don't like them, but it reminds me of Ladyfinger cookies.
Ooh, I don't like those.
Ladyfingers?
Yeah.
I like them.
I'll stick with the pretzel, sweet pretzel.
Yeah. To me, it's kind of, it's like a cross between a ginger cookie, like a ginger snap, and a peanut butter cookie. There's not a lot of peanut flavor in it, if any at all, actually. Let me look and see if I can get the texture on there.
It's smooth and creamy and crunchy at the same time.
Smooth, creamy, and crunchy all at the same time. And awesome. So yeah, we put it directly into our cake batter, and then we fold it into our buttercream. And then we put some in a piping bag, and we just drizzle it right on top of the buttercream. So when they go into the case, they are insanely good. We have some people who are devoted to it. And,
it says used by 2013. I think it'll be gone by the end of tomorrow. No problem.
Without the crunch.
What does the cookie butter cookie from Beach Bucket Bakery taste like?
Wait, is this the butter cookie butter?
Cookie butter.
Cookie butter. Is this the cookie butter cookie?
It is.
It's so good.
Eat it.
I did.
Eat another one.
It's like Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
It does taste like Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
Cinnamon Toast
Crunch. Kelly likes to torture us with her awesome creations.
Ta-da! Here they are.
Yep, and we got them. They're here for a limited time only until Jen and I eat them all. That'll be about 10 minutes from now.
I'm going to run 10 more miles today.
10 more miles?
Yeah, so I can eat.
You got to run 1 mile per cookie.
That's one, two, okay, 3 miles.
Per bag of cookies.
Wait, I ran 3 miles today anyway.
What if I drive like 8 miles? How many cookies do I get to eat?
No, ride the bike.
True. And we have some cupcakes coming out of the oven. Yay. Clove. Fun times with Beach Bucket Bakery. We have like 3 brownies left.
Four. Mm-hmm. I better come eat those.
Now that I can't eat them. Happy birthday!
Here, we're the birthday girls. So it's
you are the birthday girl. It's the exact same
Happy birthday.
Birthday.
To
same year, same
exactly.
Everything.
That's crazy.
Same hospital.
What time she was born?
Same
I
mother.
I was right born. All of that. Yeah. You gotta find out when you were born, so we can find out if it's even creepier.
Right.
I actually,
mom, I forgot what she told me. She's coming up. We're gonna spend the day together. I'll have to break
in
on Monday.
Yeah.
So yeah, your brownies. We did break into one of them yesterday,
yay.
And it was holy cow.
Good.
Seriously, seriously good.
What are you kidding?
Oh, you're flying planes. What is that, dude? Is that a plane?
That glider.
You want to see a really cool place to throw it from?
Where?
Hello.
Hey, how are you?
Where's Mary? I gotta wish her happy birthday. I know. How are you?
Up there, dude. Yeah, all the way up and just throw it down. Here, I'll see if it'll catch us. See if you can get it like down here. Go for it. Oh. That was awesome, dude. It totally went into the other restaurant. Here you go.
Everything here is peanut butter. Peanut butter, peanut butter, chocolate peanut butter. Cookie butter.
What do we have today?
A video of you guys with the cookie butter.
Buckets and shovels and areas.
Was it? I'm shooting a new video as we speak, so.
That was so funny.
I know, she was like, I thought she wanted to sword fight with the spoons at first, because she's like, chink, I'm like, what do I do? Yeah, and then we have brownies today, and
awesome.
Cookies just got here as well.
That's
so
bad.
What kind of cookies are they, Kelly?
I've got chocolate chip, cream cheese, peanut butter. I think
peanut
butter
chocolate
chip left too. Yes.
S'mores.
Yes.
S'mores, really?
Yeah, they have so much good stuff.
Oh, really? I know. It's insane.
Tim's shooting some video, so I'm gonna sneak in.
I know, I just gotta remember that part. Yep. I don't say wave wire so fast.
Here we go. I'll videotape you, videotaping us, videotaping you. And together we'll travel back in time.
Tim Shockley.
Okay. Ready and action.
Hi, my name's Tim Shockley from Virginia Beach, Virginia. I am at Shockley's Sweet Shop, and this is the Wedding Corner Tip of the Week.
Take a look at Tim's, what Tim's working on this week. Let me see the picture of it real quick. This was actually his truck.
Yep, Peterbilt.
Let me see if I can zoom in. And it's his 75th birthday?
70th birthday. Wait, 75, yep,
75.
Call name, Greedy Man.
What?
His call name's Greedy Man.
Greedy Man was his call name?
I guess
his
so.
His handle? His
yeah, yeah, we're gonna put that on this.
That's
grill.
That's awesome.
Yep, that's it.
Cool,
gonna
man.
Turn into that. Sometime.
Let me zoom in on that, okay.
That equals that.
Gonna be this. That'll be cool, dude. I like it. You are gonna elevate it too, aren't you?
Yep, and use Oreos for wheels.
Yeah, he wants the Oreos.
He loves Oreos.
Oh, that's, they bought us a bag of them, didn't they? It's funny. Sweet.
That'd be cool.
Guns.
I know.
For the second week in a row.
Yes, for the second week in a row.
We've been making.
We're putting guns on cakes.
So I'm making a
Jen
gun.
Jen drew a gun. She's gonna use that as her template. I don't know what kind of word is getting out there about us, but apparently we're a violent bakery. And we love our guns. Right, Jen? Yes.
It's gonna be awesome.
Thank you.
They better
the
like
gun, phase two. Yeah, it's all edible. And yes, it's made out of fondant that we make here by hand from scratch. Are these the pieces to it or that's the truck? Oh, that's the truck. That looks good, man. I like the wood grain on there.
Wish it would stay shiny like that.
They need to make a gloss that you can airbrush with. Yeah. Let's go look at the truck. See how the truck is doing. Coming along. And they insisted on Oreos for wheels. It's pretty cool. Fun times. Jen working on pink orchids for the weekend.
Yep.
You guys like our airbrush station? The girls come in and write their names on them and stuff.
Yep.
And Tim, putting on some more pieces to the truck, which he made yesterday.
Yep.
Mufflers.
All kinds of cool stuff.
Fun stuff. I've got a little golf cake that I'm working on. Should be cool here in a second. I can't get over this gun.
Yeah, it looks pretty good.
It does look pretty cool.
So this is Dave. And this is how you do grass. Hey Dave, show us the tip of that bag.
It's hard to see. You can't really zoom in on
yeah,
it with that camera.
That's true. But at least, so now you can see, this is how we make grass. It's very time consuming because you have to do a few blades of grass at a time.
It takes forever.
This definitely requires patience. But it's going to turn out looking just like a green.
Let's see what Jen is working on. The gun cake!
The gun cake! I just have to write words on it.
Words.
It's gonna say, happy 60th birthday,
brother, friend, daddy, husband, peepaw, marine, you mean so much to us all. Oh yeah, happy birthday, Tassie.
Here's a gun. That's cool looking, though.
That is cool looking.
Considering it's made out of marshmallows.
Yeah, I'm pretty proud of myself.
I am too. Awesome. I like the wood grain that you did in there. The handle grip.
The handle grip.
So I'm going to take Tim a strawberry ginger cupcake and let him try it since... He's the only one not on a diet here at the moment because he rides his bike 500 miles a day. So let's see what he thinks of our strawberry ginger cupcake. For those that don't know, Tim and I are huge ginger fans. Look, it's like the cupcake floating through the air.
I could afford to eat one today, but I had four yesterday.
I could too. But I'm not going to do it. Not going to do it. There's the golf cake I was working on earlier. Not too bad. It's getting there. Still more, needs more work. But.
Nice.
Truck's coming along nicely. Some giant cupcake stand Jen's working on. I don't know. All right. The floating cupcake. Hey, Tim. You're our cupcake taste tester.
Oh my gosh.
It's the strawberry ginger. Tell us what it is. Do you smell the ginger?
It smells very strawberry, but I can see chunks of ginger in there.
Yeah, chopped up the crystallized ginger. And I used the roasted ginger in it too. More or less.
I like it, I feel it.
You feel the burn?
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
Yeah, it's good.
Keep it like that?
I would.
Sweet.
Mmm.
Impressive. What are you working on right now? Oh, a wedding cake.
A four-tier. Yep. That's good.
Cool, man. Okay, here's a really quick and easy tip for you home bakers out there. This is something that we do teach in our classes, but... super, super easy to do. You can do it yourself. When you're making a cake at home and you want to fill it, let's say, for instance, this cake has a raspberry puree filling. One of the things you need to do is, it's called damming it. So you get yourself a pastry bag, fill it full of buttercream, make yourself a nice little ring around the outside of the cake, and you want to stay just to the inside, maybe a quarter of an inch, half an inch, just to the inside of the edge of your cake, okay? Make your ring, go all the way around, and then fill your cake with whatever you're using. Lemon curd, raspberry puree, chocolate ganache, white chocolate ganache, whatever you want. That way, when you put the next piece of cake right on top, and it will smush down a bit, that ring's gonna make it all the way to the edge. It's gonna keep your filling inside the cake, so it's not gonna run out the sides, but it will also make sure that your cake stays level on the outsides, because when this squishes down, that's gonna become the edge of your cake and you're not gonna get that pregnant look when you start doing your cakes. So when you have the two pieces smushing in all this good filling, you don't want that buttercream coming all the way out past the edge. Even though you can smooth that down, it'll just keep doing that. So that's why you run the ring just on the inside of the cake there. And you will avoid that little pregnant hump, especially if you start doing smoother buttercreams or throwing fondant on there and things like that. But just a little tip, easy to do. Speaking of pregnant sides, you can see this is a cake that Tim is working on right now. And notice the sides here are completely vertical, straight up and down. We get a lot of questions of how to avoid that little hump, because again, this is two pieces of cake. There is a filling in this particular cake. I believe it's a Bavarian cream. And we have a lot of questions come in about that little hump that can be created right here after the cake sits for a while. There's a couple reasons that happens. It's not always because of the buttercream underneath is being pushed out. It could be supports inside the cake. It could be a number of reasons. But that, what I was just showing you with the damming your cake and not frosting all the way to the edge, is one of the ways you can avoid that. So it's Thursday, we're constructing this cake, it's late Thursday afternoon, and this cake will be ready on Saturday, and it's still, after sitting for a little over 48 hours, it will not have that pregnant bump on the side. So again, that's just one of the things you can practice at home.
Stuff.
Marshmallow fondant.
So much better than Brand X.
So much more delicious.
Ta-da!
Big old piece of fun.
And smooth.
These cakes are so cool.
I love it. It
gets sticky.
Oh yeah, it gets quick. Sticky on the outside. Cool, so we got that cake finishing up. Here's some other pieces over here already done. Let's see, this is gonna be a cake for the case today.
What are you gonna do to it?
I don't know. Just gonna turn it into something.
I made a filling for it yesterday. A coconut filling.
But I already used it.
No, no. I made another one.
Ooh.
I made, it's in a bag. It's got a ton.
Jen, hard at work. Any tips for the home decorator?
Ta-da!
Yeah, I'll see that. Jen's piping versus mine. Mm. That's pretty smooth.
The key is to take your time. Don't rush it, and just have fun.
Take your time and don't rush it.
Yeah. Well, that's like the same thing.
But let me ask you this. I hold my breath every line I do like that, because if I'm breathing, I will exhale the whole time. Do you do anything like that?
Nope.
You just breathe naturally?
Yeah, I just do it.
Is that why I pass out every time I do a cake?
Probably.
Awesome. Dave's face down in his buttercream again.
Hey, when you bring out the glass bowl, we know what that means. Cannonballs. Dave, what flavor do we have today?
The cake is chocolate and chocolate chip. That's it.
Mm.
And then the chocolate is white chocolate, milk chocolate, and dark chocolate.
So that is a super triple chocolate cannonball, to be sure.
Ta-da!
Yeah, let's get a good video of that truck.
Good actually. Job on that truck, hon.
Yeah. No, thank you. Did you guys have fun building that? You did that, right?
That thing's awesome looking. The golden cannonball winning cake. One of the wedding cakes this week. A special golf and cannonball cake. And there's some others in box. Oh, the gun cake! Yeah, bring that out to the bar, actually. I want to get a good picture. Cannonball attempt.
That one.
That one.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, boy.
Because it's underneath it?
It is. It's inside
if
the
I
liner.
Can get under it, Dave.
Here, I got the tray.
That's funny.
Oops, not under that one. So you can check
oh,
in there.
Oh, it's not under that one.
We'll get you out.
Still like it.
We don't want that one.
This is not the candy bar.
I mean, why are there holes in the middle of the tray?
Yeah,
right.
People are being very particular.
Thank you.
So yeah, I taped your box up. Everything's good to go here. No need to refrigerate it. That's awesome. Yeah, I got pictures of this one.
Okay. I got one too, just in
the bowl. Oreos for wheels.
That's the best part of this whole cake, is the Oreo wheels.
Cool looking. We're having our golden cannonball contest this week. Under one of these cannonballs is a golden ticket.
Oh, this cake got picked up already?
Whoever wins.
Yeah. Oh, that was them.
Oh. Gets that.
Yep, one down already.
I missed that part.
And we did some Godiva white chocolate pumpkin. Godiva dark chocolate pumpkin. A few other awesome flavors. Happy Saturday.
Here we are, installing flowers. Portsmouth Renaissance. The cake is here. Four tiers separated with crystal pillars. We have an assortment of flowers here that we're choosing. And a topper to go on at the end. Chandeliers on the tables. Pretty good.
Yeah, that's gonna be great.
Spacing's just right. Mm-hmm. Pretty good. Final wedding of the day.
Oh, and get a picture of the little rhino.
The little hidden rhino here in the corner. Let me switch it to the close-up mode. There he is. He's hiding in there.
Hmm.
It looks blue. It's purple.
Hmm, it's purple.